Hi, I'm RJ Abraham. I'm a trader and algo developer. This video consists of two parts. The first section will be an overview of features of the Kairos Automated Trading Platform, with which you can implement a completely automated trading system that works with interactive brokers. We'll go over features like algorithmic stops, targets, position sizing, entry and exit conditions, allowable entry and exit times, and scanning of symbols in real time. In the second section, in less than 5 minutes, we will step through how to implement a fully automated trading system, and then we'll show the trading system in action. I'll show you just how easy it is for you to implement your own trading system and fully automate it in minutes. Documentation for the features seen in the video can be accessed in the comments section below. Click below to subscribe to the channel so that you can be notified when more videos are released. This is the Kairos Automated Trading Platform. Let me give you a brief introduction that explains the tools that you use to automate your trading system in just 5 minutes. You log in, go to the toolbar, it's very simple. I'm going to walk you through how to implement an automated trading system. There are three easy steps. First, you set up your trading system conditions in one window. This is it. Using one window, you can set up and execute a completely automated trading system. You set up your entry conditions, stops, targets, entry times, exit times, exit criteria, and position sizing and entry times on specific symbols as well. Put the entry conditions here, either long or short. You can put exit criteria here, or you can use one of the 21 types of algorithmic stops and 5 types of targets, including scale outs. Second, connect to interactive brokers or run in simulation mode. Third, select your symbols to trade, start scanning, and connect to IB. Now, when symbols meet the entry conditions of the trading system, they are sent to interactive brokers and then tracked according to the stop, target, and exit criteria of the trading system. You don't have to write complex code to connect to IB. You don't have to waste time writing scripts to generate indicators. You can generate as many trading systems as you want, each with its own criteria and each trading its own set of symbols. If you want, you could have 5 systems trading futures, 2 trading equities, and another trading Forex. That's it. That's all you have to do to create your own automated algorithmic trading system. Now let's walk through setting up a simple futures trading system. This material is for educational purposes only, and the content should not be construed as being a recommendation of any kind. No representation is being made that any trading system or method is likely to achieve profits or losses similar to the ones discussed here. The system will go long when it's above the previous day's high and short below the previous day's low, and when the rate of change of the moving average is above or below a threshold. Like I said, a very simple trading system. We will then set stops and targets, start scanning the future symbols, and connect to interactive brokers. Let's get started. First, we want to bring up the conditions window. We want to write a condition that uses the 1 minute close greater than previous day high. On the left-hand side, we have the 1 minute close selected in the intraday 1 minute time frame. In the middle, we have the greater than sign, and on the right-hand side, we have the high of the previous day. We're going to call it I1 close greater than previous day high. Next, we're going to save as this condition. We're going to create a condition that says the 1 minute close is less than the previous day low. We will call it I1 close less than PD low, or previous day low, and we'll save that. Next, we want to go to the indicator. We want to write a 21 period simple moving average. So here we're selecting the simple moving average, putting the period in for 21. We're going to do this on the 1 minute close. We're going to call it I1 SMA underscore 21.
Now we're going to create a rate of change indicator based on the simple moving average indicator that we just created. The rate of change will have a period of 3 and a multiply by of 1000. We'll use the simple moving average that we just created, and we'll call the rate of change indicator name I1ROC3_1000_21, and we'll save it. Now, using this rate of change indicator, we want to go back to the conditions window. We want to create two conditions, one that is specifies it's above a threshold, and another that shows specifies that it's below a threshold. This one, the left-hand side, takes the 1 minute rate of change, and if we want to say that it's greater than a threshold of 5, we'll call it I1ROC3_greater_than_the_threshold. We'll save this, and then we'll create the second condition. This one, we want the rate of change to be less than a minus threshold, or minus 5 in this case. We'll call this condition I1ROC3_minus_threshold, and we'll save it. Now we'll go to the modules window. Here we will configure a new trading system or module by adding. We're going to add the four conditions that we just created, 2 for the long side and 2 for the short side. And then we're going to look at the other tabs. The symbols we want to disable because we want to have every symbol that's scanned, we want it alerted. We're going to enable the execution for the module. We're going to set the exit all time positions time to 355, so that for any positions open at 355, it will close. And we'll set the module max capital to 20,000. We'll set the quantity to 1. Then we'll go for the stop. We'll set a fixed tick stop of 8 ticks. And we'll set a closing strategy of limit with a cancel timeout of 30 seconds. We don't need to set the stop route because it's for a future trading system. For the target, we'll set a fixed tick, target value of 16 ticks. With a closing strategy of limit persist and target price strategy of split bid ask. For position sizing, we'll disable that because position sizing is used for equity trading systems primarily. Then we will save the module name as futures simple ROC trading system. We'll save this, and you can see that we have created a very simple futures trading system in under 5 minutes. Now the next step is to actually start scanning the symbols that we want alerted. So here we start real time. We're going to scan these 5 to 6 future symbols. Once we do that, we will have to bring up the module window. When we bring up the module window, this will alert us as to when the conditions are met for that module. So now that it's completed scanning and it's updating in real time, we go to the module icon there. We click on this module that we just created. Now it will be alerted as soon as those conditions are met for long or short. Then we connect the Kairos Automated Trading Platform to Interactive Brokers. Now, at this point, when it's alerted, it will send the execution. It'll send the order to the Interactive Brokers platform. So here we just have the Japanese yen meet the criteria. We're going to look at the chart to see that the rate of change was above 5 in this case. So we're going to put the rate of change indicator and the 21 period moving average there. We can see that the rate of change was greater than 5. So now we'll look at some of the other executions. We will have 2 other futures contracts executed here. As it turns out, I fast forwarded through this, let you get a feel of how it operates. There are 3 futures contracts that get executed, and they all hit the targets in this case. So we have the British pound, the Japanese yen, and the euro. And I'm going to fast forward. This takes about 15 to 20 minutes for them to all hit their targets, but they exit out sequentially. Here the euro got exited, hit its target. And we'll fast forward again. And the second futures contract hit its target. And finally, the final one is exited.
Thank you for your time and attention. Click below and subscribe to the channel to be notified when more videos are released. Please comment below. Let me know what topics you'd like to see covered in future videos. See you in the next video, and happy algo trading.